Welcome back, students. We were discussing the topic enzymes. So now we will have a discussion on factors affecting the enzyme action. Now, enzyme action is affected by temperature. Little activity at low temperature. That means at low temperature, the enzymes are inactive and the rate increases with temperature. Enzymes generally function at a narrow range of temperature, and the temperature at which the enzyme shows its maximum activity, or you can say it's more active, it is called as its optimum temperature. And usually the optimum temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. And usually human beings also have the optimum temperature, you can say the body temperature of human beings is 37 degrees Celsius. The activity lost with denaturation is at high temperature. That means at high temperature, the enzyme, or you can say the protein, can be denatured and its activity is lost. As you can see in the figure, as the rate of reaction increase at low temperature, enzyme is, or you can say the rate of reaction is less, but as it increases at optimum temperature is 37 degrees Celsius, and as the temperature is increased, the enzyme, or you can say the rate of reaction, is lowered. Next factor affecting the enzyme action is substrate concentration. Now, with the increase in the substrate concentration, the velocity of enzyme catalyzed reaction increases. Now, increasing the substrate concentration increases the rate of reaction. So, enzyme concentration is constant. While when you keep on adding the substrate, or if you are constantly increasing the substrate, the rate of reaction would be increasing. The rate of reaction would be increasing while the enzyme concentration is constant. Now, maximum activity reached when all the enzyme combines with the substrate. Now, this is because all the active site of the enzymes are occupied by the substrate molecules. That is, the enzyme molecules are fewer than the substrate molecules, and after saturation, there is no free molecule to bind to the substrate. As you can see here, the rate of reaction and the substrate concentration. As you're constantly increasing the substrate concentration, the maximum activity of enzyme is observed. Next factor affecting the enzyme action is pH. Now, like temperature, each enzyme also has a optimum pH and which the enzyme activity is maximum. Now, the R group of amino acids have proper charge and the tertiary group of enzyme is correct. Now, the changes in the pH of the medium alter the tertiary structure of the enzyme, and thereby the enzyme activity is decreased. Now, most loss activity in the low or high pH. That means at like temperature, the enzyme at low pH, or at very low pH or very high pH, the enzyme action is lost. As you can see in the figure, optimum temperature is 7. And while at 3 and while at 11, the enzyme activity is, or you can say the rate of reaction is lowered. So students, in this session we have seen the factors affecting enzyme action. In further session we will have again some more discussion on enzymes. Thank you.